NIO shares are down now because of Beijing's recent clampdown on US-listed Chinese companies, along with global semiconductor shortage. Then is it the right time to buy dip in NIO? Please watch the video till the very end to see my perspective about it. Hi, my name is Sunny and I make videos that affect a common man financially. If you're new to this channel, please smash that like button as that will help me with the YouTube algorithm and it will be highly appreciated. It is a big Chinese EV maker that make good-looking electric cars mainly for Chinese market that has seen a huge run-up in its stock price last year. They have doubled their production and sales of EVs in quarter one of 2021 as compared to last year, along with rapid expansion of their battery swap stations and its expansion into Norway. So in a nutshell, they are doing everything right to capture the largest EV market in the world, China. Maybe that is the reason they are called Tesla killer, at least in China, where they are trying to gain the market share. I have made a detailed video why NIO is called Tesla killer, and I will leave the link in the description too. But lately, they are facing some challenges that is affecting their stock price, and that is why it is down about 6% year to date. The general sell-off in Chinese companies trading on US stock markets, which came in the backdrop of recent Chinese crackdown on their local big technology companies. It all started with Alibaba, Tencent, and the recent one is DD Global Inc., which is the raid hailing app based out of China listed on NASDAQ. The other major global factor is global semiconductor chip shortage, which is affecting all major automakers worldwide. It can be a short-term challenge for NIO to meet its second quarter vehicle delivery targets too. These are two very important factors affecting NIO stock, and let's dive into a little more detail about both of them. China is stepping up oversight of its companies listed on US exchanges. The reason given is cross-border data flows and security. This will not only threaten the IPOs in the pipeline, but could also affect the already listed Chinese companies on US exchanges. This is clearly evident in Invesco's Global Dragon ETF, which tracks US listed Chinese shares of companies that are based out of mainland China, who have lost one-third of their value from its February peak because of increased Chinese regulatory pressure. There are more than 200 Chinese companies listed on three major US exchanges with a market cap of over $2 trillion. Because of this geopolitics back and forth between China and the United States, the US investors need to weigh in the risk of owning Chinese companies at a time when this regulatory crackdown is going on, but right now there is no indication that NIO might be on that list. Recently, the semiconductor chip shortage has affected all automakers worldwide. Some have been forced to shut down their plants, while others have slowed down their production because of it. We need to realize that today's cars are not mechanical devices. Instead, they're complex electronics on wheels, the heart of which are semiconductor chips. The pandemic and the lifestyle change after that, where everything went online, this increased the demand for electronics and semiconductors, thus this chip shortage. NIO is expecting this global chip shortage to drag down the vehicle deliveries for some time, whereas the recent fire at a Japanese chip factory is not helping either. Once on the brink of bankruptcy, NIO is expanding at a rapid pace, first starting with Norway. But experts are saying they will be entering the major global market by 2023 and beyond. Don't get me wrong, it has got a long way to go with the global ambition if it has to match the scale of big daddy of EV, Tesla, but what NIO has achieved in this short period of time is nothing but commendable. Recently, the Chinese government has allowed companies to sell EVs without batteries, which is seen by many as paving the way for NIO to launch its battery as a service product. It is an incentive for a car buyer where they can buy a car without a battery. Instead, the customers can buy a battery plan for about $140 a month, which will reduce the entry barrier for many EV buyers because this will reduce the cost of a new car by about $10,000. It has formed a new battery asset company where the initial three investors are CATL, a local financial company, and Hubei Science and Technology Investment, with each having 25% equity stake. The whole idea is to give battery swap technology and its ecosystem a push, which will benefit NIO in gaining market share eventually in China. In my limited wisdom, I think NIO is doing everything right at the moment, which would help it gain market share at a very rapid pace. The Chinese government's helping hand for local homegrown EV champion over American Tesla can be a major factor in NIO becoming successful. Don't get me wrong. If you're buying NIO, it has to be for the long term, as nothing is going to drastically change in the short term. In spite of the short-term challenges it is facing now, I am of the view there is a bright future ahead for this company. I am a long-term NIO shareholder and I continue to remain bullish on the stock, but I am keeping a close watch on the recent regulatory clampdown by China and its possible effects on NIO. As Warren Buffett said famously, and I quote, "Be fearful when everybody's greedy and be greedy when everybody's fearful," close quote. But that is me. Every investor has a different risk profile and investment time horizon. Take your time, talk to a financial advisor as I am not, then make up your own mind and invest when you are comfortable. This is my take on the topic, NIO buying the dip. If you like the content that I make, please help me and my channel by liking, sharing, and subscribing to it. Thanks for watching. See you next time in the next video on your own channel, Sunny Snippets.